Congratulations to you. You've managed to click on a YouTube video on this issue that's not just a lot of words flashing up on a screen and music made on some 8-bit music system from the 1980s. I'm a real person with real opinions of why I think Chick-fil-A has failed in the UK. First of all, what's been wildly and widely announced in the media worldwide, be it social media or mainstream media, is because of their stance against LGBT and they're against gay marriage and all that. Now, that's a great way to alienate a lot of customers right there, isn't it? So there's been protests as well. And, you know, it's fine to have that thought process. It's perfectly fine to project that kind of attitude in many countries around the world. But in the UK, we're a bit more switched on. And we're much more progressive, and we don't believe in that kind of rubbish. You know, that kind of thought process, much like a chicken, doesn't fly very far, Chick-fil-A. Now, let's move on, because that's all been covered in the media. I've got other reasons why I think it was always going to struggle. First of all, the name. Chick-fil-A. It's a stupid name. You know, we don't say fillet in the UK. No, we say fillet. Chicken fillet. Fish fillet. Fillet. The pronunciation or pronunciation, whatever you like, which sounds much more continental, funny enough, didn't cross the English Channel, so it's not going to be able to cross the Atlantic. It's a weird name, Chick-fil-A. Chick-fil-A. It just doesn't sound right. It just doesn't sit on the ear quite right. Then there was the location of the store. Why Reading? Of all places, Reading. Now that I've angered everybody in Reading. I'm sure it's a lovely place. Maybe it isn't. Maybe it's a dump. I don't know. But the point is, it's not a major city, is it? It's not London. Now, if the company was being too tight and they couldn't be bothered to put in the budget to really make this thing work properly and they shied away, or maybe they was complacent. Big companies do silly things all the time. Look at West Farmers with its Bunnings brand. They thought they could just storm into the UK, take over a, you know, relatively profitable DIY chain and fill that chain with outdoor furniture, barbecues, jacuzzis, gazebos. In a country where you're lucky if your garden is bigger than a postage stamp and where the winter lasts only about 3 weeks. Have Chick-fil-A done the same thing? Have they thought, we can just open a store anywhere and the English will lap it up. Or the British will lap it up. It doesn't work like that. Because you know what? It might be smaller than a map, but it's just a big country as well. Now, moving swiftly on to that point of just opening somewhere random. Why not open it in a centre of another big city in the UK? Because there's plenty of them. Why not Manchester, Birmingham, Bristol, Leeds, Bradford, Liverpool, Newcastle? They could have picked any major city in the UK and gone into the centre of it, not paid as much and still made a lot of money. But instead they chose the very, very, well, it's not even the very outskirts of London. I've got my news sources on this issue from as many places as possible, but only, I think it was Fox News, said it was an hour and a half drive away from London. Is it? Is it really? Is that as the crow flies? Because I'm pretty sure it takes longer than that, Fox News. I think that's an hashtag Fox News fact, because it's not an hour and a half away from London to Reading, because people's idea of what London is different as well. For instance, to me, anywhere with a tube station and red buses is London. To other people, it's anywhere within the M25. To other people, it's only the very centre of London, Zone 1. I don't know where they got the hour and a half from. Another reason why I think Chick-fil-A, I just want to call it chicken fillet. Can't just call it Chick-fil-A, Chick-fil. Chick it. It's the competition in the UK. Once again, I think it's complacency from the big company again, thinking, oh, it's only little old England. We can open up anywhere. I think another reason why it's failed is because it's a fail to grasp the competition. There's loads and loads of cheap fast food places. There are loads and loads of restaurant chains. There are even more independents as well. With good quality and there's bad quality. There's the sort of quality where you don't really care about, but the price is good. You know what I mean? You've got the full range, like every country in the world. But it seems as if this Chick-fil-A company has opened up with such a silly budget. It just, something doesn't sound right. Why? I mean, we're too busy as well. I mean, much like America, if we're at work, we need to get someone to go to that place for us to bring the food to us. So we'll get some like Deliveroo or Uber Eats or Just Eat to go out and get it for us. It's totally an ill-judged, bad opening of the company in the UK. I just don't understand what the thought that was doing. I mean, take away all this LGBT thing and their stance against gay marriage. There is a lot of other issues. For instance, even the food quality and the way the food is reared and produced in the UK, the laws are going to be different. Staff laws as well, staff rights are completely different. I think the operating costs are probably way more in the UK than they are in America because of the minimum wage and the living wage and the rights of how food is produced and where it comes from. Because obviously as well, the different standards in what injections your food can have and what the car and that sort of law as well. The competition from KFC, which is obviously their biggest competitor. I mean, KFC is well rooted into the UK now. And I don't particularly like buying chicken from a fast food place, but if I'm really forced to in the really strange random locations, if I'm not two steps away from a McDonald's, if I do have to go to a Burger King, I'll probably get the Chicken Royale. But that's just a personal thing. But the point of the fact is there are huge, big chains and there's the independents, which are massive competition. Nando's, I would rather go to Nando's. If I'm going to buy something chickeny, I want something substantial in the sense of something that's better than just fast food. I know some people would class Nando's as fast food and not substantial, but it's that strange thing going on. But yeah, Chick-fil-A didn't have a chance, not in the UK. That sort of silly opening. I mean, what company as well says, oh yeah, we only plan to open for 6 months. Don't really ring true, does it? I mean, did you tell your staff that? Welcome. You've got your new job. By the way, keep your CV ready because you're going to be on the dole again in 6 weeks. 6 months, rather. You see what I mean? It just doesn't ring true. There's lots of issues here. If they try opening any other stores in the UK, they would have to try a lot harder than they did. And they would have to really open up a separate company in the UK with a separate head office so far away from the American side of the business that it could possibly be its own entity. But I don't think any of that's going to happen, is it? Because why would they do that as well? Anyway, thanks for watching. Please scratch bell me. Let me know in the comment section down below. Do you agree with me? Do you disagree with me? Scratch. Subscribe, comment, rate and share. And bell me. That's the bell bit next to the notifications and whatnot. Thanks for watching. Scratch bell me. Bye.